Parents in a couple local districts don't have the stress of deciding how kids return to school. Instead, the school system is making the choice. That's what John Shumway is looking into for us this morning. This is interesting.
Yeah, parents in, and I know they're relieved, Riverview and the Carleton school districts don't have to make the decision. In fact, the districts have decided to start the school year totally online. At Carleton, it's a quarantine for anyone who may visit a COVID hotspot right before school begins. So for the first 4.5 weeks, it's all online at Carleton, which Superintendent Dr. John Kreider says requires getting all the students on a level technology learning field.
Every student will have a computer. We've purchased those computers. We're in the process of tagging those computers and getting them prepared for our students. And we'll approach this year in the same manner as if students need accessibility issues or have accessibility issues, we'll make sure that they have connection in their homes and be able to have access to our curriculum online.
Let's go back to the social interaction part, Dr. Kreider, because I've talked to child psychologists who say that is so crucial, especially in the younger ages.
That face-to-face environment is very, very difficult to replace, and kids benefit from that interaction with one another. So Carleton School District is committed to getting students back into the classroom when we deem it to be safe. And those are the different types of metrics that we'll use is throughout the course of the first 4.5 weeks to make that determination of when we feel it's safe to bring our kids back to school.
There are a lot of kids in Western Pennsylvania who depend on school breakfast and lunches. In some cases, it may be the only really decent meals they get in a day. How do you fill that void when you're doing online?
We set up food distribution sites at our elementary schools as well as other strategic locations in the community where students or parents can report to those places to pick up both a lunch and a breakfast for the following day.
Dr. Kreider says teachers will teach from their classrooms because some things can't be replicated, like a science teacher needs a lab in order to be able to do demonstrations. Then, after the 4.5 weeks, Dr. Kreider hopes to get the kids back into the school in some form, but based on what happens with COVID cases, they could have to revert again back to going all online. And while we were out at the school yesterday, we saw the cheerleaders practicing. We saw the band out there. We know the PIAA is pushing ahead for fall sports to happen. But Dr. Rachel Levine yesterday said they're looking at it. Right now, they haven't made any decisions on that.
Just a couple weeks ago, we had this conversation. You all at home joined in online, too, about, the guilt that comes along with making this tough decision.
Right.
So it's interesting to see a school district just saying, this is what we're doing. No options.
Yeah, in some districts, their deadlines are looming right on these parents right now. It's tough.
It is tough. All right. Thanks, Shum, so much.